Damn.
Just yesterday. Her daughter is an artist. So there's not enough for her. So I set off. And I did.
Okay, look, family. Jeffrey, turn around.
One of the radio stations.
Yeah, but not like. You stop.
So, were you watching a game tonight? Herman, were you watching a game tonight? My bet. Yeah, just like
I said.
Karen, I thought about you the whole time at the games. Do you have a great time?
But that was the wrong game to go to.
Yeah.
I agree. So, anyway, that's our struggle right now.
And we'll go over here and get Grace.
You pick everything else.
You're being photographed. Is that enough?
Yeah.
Oh, there's a close-up. Ooh.
Where's Jennifer? Why don't you get her hair so
straight?
JPI Secular B'nai Mitzvah harkens back to the traditional bar mitzvah as a rite of passage from childhood to adulthood. Surprisingly, the exact origin of the bar mitzvah is uncertain, most likely derived from tribal custom. By the first century, this milestone event invoked the obligation to observe the commandments and to participate in the rituals of the community. Although the Bible does not directly mention the bar mitzvah ceremony, it has come to have profound meaning for Jews. It is the Talmud that assigns the age of 13 as an age when a vow is made valid and when one becomes subject to the commandments.
At JPI, we have taken the single bar or bat mitzvah and made it plural, the B'nai mitzvah. More importantly, we have taken the concept of the mitzvah, the good deed, and interpreted it literally. We have asked our children not only to study the good deeds of heroic figures, but also to do good deeds themselves. We are especially proud of the 32 hours of community service that each of these young people have devoted to their community. Indeed, over the past year of study and work, we have watched our children grow into adulthood with a mature understanding of the ethical principles and responsibilities that accompany Jewish life. Today's B'nai Mitzvah ceremony joyfully recognizes their rite of passage.
I, Jonathan Jonas, light the candle of tradition.
Thank you.
freedom.
I, Lauren Wisely, light the candle of justice.
Light the candle of peace.
Jennifer was always ready to learn. I never heard one word of complaint from Jennifer about all the assignments we had. Jennifer always did her assignments on time. She was enthusiastic about all she has done. Jennifer has displayed a maturity which supported our B'nai Mitzvah group in moving forward through this past year. Lauren.
Hello, my name is Jennifer Walmer. Today I'm being B'nai Mitzvah. For my research, I learned about Gilda Radner. Gilda Radner is known best as an actress and comedian. She is famous for her unusual characters and her improvisational skills. As one of the stars on Saturday Night Live, she made millions of people laugh. What she was not known for is her courageous battle against ovarian cancer. Laughter was an important part of Gilda's life. She used humor to help her cope with her disease and to educate others about cancer. Many of Gilda's experiences as a child taught the value of laughter. Gilda was born and raised in Detroit, Michigan. Gilda and her father were very close. Herman Radner loved to entertain Gilda and her brother, and he was the one who encouraged her performing abilities. Gilda's dad passed away when she was only 14. Gilda starred in Saturday Night Live for 5 seasons, from 1975 to 1980. Some of the roles were Brownie, Judy Miller, which was her favorite character, and Roseanne Rosanna Dana. In 1980, she made her first movie called First Family, and then she was in That Woman in Red and Hanky Panky. During these movies, she met Gene Wilder and fell in love with him. They got married in 1984 and acted in another movie together called Haunted Honeymoon. Gilda's movies were not very successful, but she had found the love of her life. When she quit Saturday Night Live, she began a career as a writer. Gene Wilder and Gilda tried many years to have a baby, but after a while, Gilda knew something must be wrong. In 1986, Gilda was diagnosed with ovarian cancer. Many members of her family had died from some kind of cancer at a young age. Gilda worked very hard to make people laugh. It was her dream since she was a child. She knew she accomplished her dream when she found out to make an audience laugh. She even tried to make people laugh about cancer and tried to educate them about this disease. She was only 44 when she died on May 20, 1989. Before Gilda died, she wrote a funny but yet serious book about her life and her battle against cancer. This book was called It's Always Something. Gilda requested that her husband Gene Wilder organize cancer support groups all around the world. Gilda's Club is a free counseling community center for cancer patients that opened up in New York City in 1995. People with cancer and their families meet with others for emotional support. The Gilda's clubs throughout the country offer welcome meetings, social events and gatherings, workshops and self-esteem, various therapies, and relaxation and stress reduction are all offered there. There is even a giggle room, a place to laugh with people who understand. There are now Gilda's clubs opening in many cities throughout the country as part of her legacy. As part of my community service, I was a volunteer for the Gildas Family Walking Block Party. These events raise money for the Detroit Gildas Club. Just this year, a house in Royal Oak, Michigan opens its doors for cancer victims and their families. I'll contribute some of my bat mitzvah money there. I also volunteered for two other events that raise money for the cancer. They are Race for the Cure and the Lincoln Mercury Amazing Maze. These events also help to teach people about cancer prevention and to make the public more aware of how everyone can help in the battle against this disease. Just this year, on April 19th, over 15,000 people participated in Race for the Cure at the Detroit Zoo. 75% of the money will go towards breast cancer research, screening, and education in the Detroit area. If we all pitched in, we could fight the everlasting battle against cancer. In conclusion, I would like to end my speech with the words of Gilda Radner. If indeed God created this world and then left us on our own to work things out, then getting together with other people and communicating is the most magic thing we have. Thank you.
May we raise our voices more in happiness at what they are than in vexation at what they are not. Blessed you are, children.
Beside a brave, gloomy sky, tomorrow will be clear and bright.
This is a toast to our children as we share this day with our friends and relations gathered here. We have watched you mature just as the grapes on the vine have ripened, and today we offer you our best wishes. May your lives be forever fruitful and satisfying. May you learn the value of life and affirm its beauty through fulfillment and joy. May you learn to cherish your freedom as Jews and Americans. May you use your knowledge to build with others a world of peace and dignity for all.
Wilner. Kevin Klayman.
There's George. George of the round goal. There's
that
Jeffrey.
The
barely new.
Oh my God.
And there's Pat.
That is so nice.
Jeffrey. And you know what you can do about this?
Is it recording?
Yeah. Whoa, is that close?
Isn't that where they take it and then they put it on a computer screen or something like that?
You put it on a regular TV.
Well, it's got it right there. You know what you're supposed to do. You know, you have to pose for something.
You don't have to pose.
No, you can move. It's like a video.
Oh, you can move around?
Yeah.
Nice to be
here. Is that one of those digitals?
And there's Andrew and Diana working away for the end of the food.
Turn that thing off.
Look how pretty this is. Look at that.
Taking care of a baby.
Oh, that's beautiful.
That.
Very pretty.
Here.
Looks good.
There's Uncle Dick and Uncle Paul. And Uncle Andrew. Hello. It works better if it's on a tripod, but then I can't move.
Do you have to move real slowly?
Ooh, well, Jennifer, I think I took your picture earlier today.
But you gotta get on the phone.
And there's Toothman. Toothman. Did you get warmed up, honey?
Hi. No.
There's Miss Gambling Brookie.
We can't find him.
And there's Miss Gambling Lindsay.
What happened to you guys?
What is that?
Say hi.
Hi. Medical relief.
You guys disappeared.
That's a
in like the 50s or something?
Yeah.
Why is that? Did Jennifer like that period?
Right.
Oh.
Juliet Weaver.
Oh.
big smiles, everyone. Okay? Nice smiles, and we are going to have to switch.
Or no?
I love it.
It's easier. I mean, see, I just, what I thought was hard was used to filming this way. I mean, it's
Yeah, but you can draw it in nice and close. Really close. And then if, oh, there's a handsome looking man.
Thank you.
And then you can you can hold it out here, but you can tip that to where you want it. Where is he? Oh, he's hiding behind. There he is.
Plate of hors d'oeuvres, you thought that was dinner.
Whoa, that's not dinner. That's just an appetizer.
Yeah. six, seven, eight.
Personality plus. She makes friends with perfect strangers, and she has charmed all of us. Because she's so energetic and really lots of fun, the Candle of Enthusiasm is great grandma for number one. Great grandma!
Thank you, man.
And great food everywhere. On my birthday, I'm treated like a real VIP. My grandparents take me out to dinner and usually on a shopping spree. I've always felt very lucky to have them at my side. Great Grandma, Grandma and Grandpa, please light the candle of devotion, which I extend to you, Pride. Great Grandma and Grandpa, please come light the candle to with me.
Did you blow it?
No, I got it.
Oh, you're still
for a birthday celebration. It's so great to take a swim in their pool at Boca Raton. While people back in Michigan have their boots and mittens on. We seek treasures at the flea market and do jigsaw puzzles too. When they're back in Chicago, we find other cool things to do. Nan and Papa, I invite you to come light candle three with me. It's candle of affection with love for you from me.
Love, baby, don't hurt me. Don't hurt me. No more. Baby, don't hurt me. Don't hurt me. No more.
I know, I can feel it.
I don't know, you're not there.
I bridge the distance between Michigan and Illinois. We always use our email. It's a letters writer's joy. During winter vacations, we catch up with each other's lives. In Boca Raton at Nana's, we can't wait till everyone arrives. Danny's extremely creative with his animation art. His color shapes and figures really set his talents apart. As I've been growing up, I relied on Megan's advice. She's like an older sister, which I think is really nice. My mom's twin aunt Ellen are like aunt. My mom's twin is Aunt Ellen. She and Uncle George are a team. She's a great cook and teacher, and he's a homemaker's dream. He can fix any problem faucet. His paintings are really first rate. He also irons his own clothing, which any wife would appreciate. I'm so thrilled that they are with us this weekend, and I have given them the candle of four. It's the candle of creativity. Nothing suits the trends anymore. Sensual mood, motion. Any exercise or sport has a loyalty and devotion. My Aunt Laura and Uncle Andy are quite busy people too. Sailing, fishing, and skiing are the things they love to do. It's always such fun to see them, especially to share a meal. Special requests in my uncle's kitchen are never a big deal. When thinking of a good candle for the Craig family to light, I chose the candle of adventure, which I think is exactly right. Aunt Laura, Uncle Andy, Jake, and Christopher, please light candle 5 with me. Always met Aunt Grace and Uncle Paul. Dad and his brother get excited when MSU gets the ball. My aunt is a wonderful artist with stamps, invitations, and beads. If an object lacks shapes or color, she always knows what it needs. Lindsay likes to know what I think about different things. She collects Beanie Babies, and it's fun to see which ones she brings. Regardless of the subject, Brooke can read it well. From all the books she's gone through, she has lots of stories to tell. All four of them are invited, whether it's June or December, and I think it's Candle of Imagination fits these family members. But their house is truly their castle when they reunite. They relax in the home that was built in the style of Frank Lloyd Wright. Besides having many treasures to remind me of the place they've seen, they have clothing and neat souvenirs from China or the Philippines. We call them the mystery couple because we talk to them online, but they're here tonight in person, and the pleasure is truly mine. and Lou and Uncle Bob, please light candle 7 with me, the candle of success. Trace their friendship back to sixth grade. They agree that they're among best friends each has ever made. Barbara's always laughing at some silly joke or fun. When we spend time with her and Michael, we can't stop but help. We can't help but have loads of fun. She and Michael appreciate the finer things in life. A beautiful concert or painting, always pleasure. And this husband and wife. Barbara herself is very, very talented too. When she's seated at her piano, she can really entertain you. When thinking of the candle for friends of the Perlsteins to light, the candle of culture strikes me as the one that's exactly right. Barbara and Michael, please come and help me light candle 8. Treat me like royalty, with chocolates on my pillow and nasty Monty. When the Tigers are in town, we might catch a game board together, or they'll take me to a concert. Hey, we don't care about the weather. We like to ride the People Mover when we go to Greek Town. I always have a great time when Peter and Karen are around. Karen's one of those people who lends others a helping hand. We volunteer together every chance we can. She got me real involved with Race for the Cure. This nurse makes people feel better. Of that, you can't be sure. When we've gone on family trips, like Disney or Mexico, it's always much more fun when Peter and Karen also go. He's won me stuffed animals and did something else I treasure. He sent me flowers on our anniversary. Now that was quite a pleasure. Some people will do anything for you, and Peter's that kind of guy. He is generosity by nature that money just can't buy. He and Karen always show me the greatest hospitality, that I want to give them both the candle of generosity. Peter and Karen, please come light candle 9. I know I never sit still. From the Grand Canyon to the Mirage, our days are always a thrill. We like exploring out west, where we hike and go for a stroll. This summer we're going to Yellowstone and we'll visit the Jackson Hole. There's never a dull moment when you travel with your best friend. The Eisenbergs is candle activity because our good times never end. Evan, Alexa, Beth, and Bruce, please help me light candle 10. Who know me as well as anyone could. Katie and Nita know just how to make me feel good. We borrow each other's brushes, and we like to compare our clothes. We share secrets and conversations that nobody else ever knows. Whether we're sleeping over or shopping at the mall, these are two buddies who I will tell all. Katie and Nita, please help me light the candle to end the candle of friendship. When something's on our minds, it's a good time to unload. We hit Birmingham in the movies or just listen to CDs. It's fun to be out of school, then we just do what we please. Now the night is young, but still so are we. So kick up your heels and come and party with me. I'd like to have all my guy and girls friends come up and help me with Candle 12.
One more time, here we go, big smiles. One, two, three.
Every admirer with the grin you have worn. A very easy baby, you were cuddly and real sweet. You never fussed around with new people you'd meet. We've been proud to watch you grow into the young lady you are now. In our family this weekend, you're the undisputed star. You've helped important causes like Race for the Cure. Your commitment and sincerity has always been mature.
You're a great daughter and friend, and you're fun to be around, even though you take the phone from our room without a single sound. With your irresistible humor and your sunny disposition, in the personality department, you have no competition. To know you is to love you, and Jennifer, we do. We're always entertained by the many things you do. With pride, we now toast you on your bat mitzvah success and hope that life will bring you perfect happiness.
Jennifer's cake are aglow, and we need each and every one of you to help her blow them out. So I'm going to ask her to make a wish at this time. Let me know when you have one. You've got one. Good. You've been thinking about this, I see. And then I'm going to count down from three. They're going to blow out the candles with your help, and then we're all going to sing absolutely the loudest round of happy birthday that Jennifer's ever heard. So here we go. 3, 2, 1, blow. You're not helping. And
happy birthday to you.
Louder.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jennifer.
Now on key.
Happy birthday to you.
All right. Now, ladies and gentlemen, get this cake out of the way with some help. I think. Here we go. I got a volunteer. What do you know? Now, as you can see, the Wilmers are standing up here. We don't want them to be alone. And before we give you your dinner, we're going to get you all up here on the dance floor. And we need to do something for tradition's sake, of course. Something. That was a wake-up call for Jennifer. So please, get out of your chairs. As you already are, and come on out to the floor and join us. For the horror. Now, as you can see, the Wilmers are standing in the center. They look kind of lonely. I'm going to count to three, and we're all going to walk right on the count of three. Wait a second. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, ho! Get those hands up. Keep it right there for the camera, guys. Good job. And let's bring her on down. Now, we know Julie's not afraid to fly after all, so we're going to ask Miss Six to grab a seat as well. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, go. Nothing like jet lag. Spin. They're choreographing this. Look out. All right, now let's bring her on down. What do you think the chances of getting Terry to go grab a seat in that chair? Terry, come on. All right, gentlemen, now be careful. 1, 2, 3, go. Watch your head. We don't want to box them through the ceiling. Because guess who's coming to the center? Oh, yeah, Jeff, grab a seat. Here we go. Uh-oh, look out. No, that doesn't work. Don't even try it. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, so. You grab your dad's hand and your mom's hand and your sister's hand and everybody else. Kind of fall in line. We're taking it. Here we go. Ooh, the big turn. works right. We're going to use both these dance floors to wind it on out. Here we go. Stay nice and wide. You got to walk all the way around the floor, all the way. Twist it on down. Just don't bump into people. Keep your hands out. Oh, my God. Wait, hold. We made it through the tough one. Oh, we got to the outside. People are crashing left and right. Wind it down. It's getting claustrophobic in there. We had to get out. Come on. Amazing. We're back here. Now, like all dance contests that you gotta count, you gotta start by clapping your hands so we get on beat. 5, 6, 7, 8. You just gotta listen to me and I promise I'll get you started. And you gotta pay attention because I may change the rules as we go. Get set. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, freeze. 5, 6, 7, 8, dance. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, freeze. Shoulder, that means you are out. Go right to the edge of the floor. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's a big move on you. I like it. Thank you. First of all, guys, you gotta move your feet. You can't just clap. Now, everybody freeze. Nobody move. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, freeze. 5, 6, 7, 8, and 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Remember, we need you to keep your eyes shut. Don't open your eyes. You can only say we have our winner. And go grab someone who's not dancing and bring them right out to the floor.
Your love is a pearl.
Get a snowball, go find someone who's not dancing and bring them on out to the floor.
And all the lessons we will learn will be beautiful and strange. We'll have our fill of tears, our share of sighs.
Once again, we ask our couples to please snowball, go grab someone who's not dancing and bring them on out to the floor. Get out of your chairs. Once dance again. Everybody on the floor. Elmo, I'll go find somebody who's not dancing and bring them on out.
What are you doing?
Who are still in their seats to please come on out and join us on the floor. And this time, go ahead and grab that special someone and bring them on out to the floor. All of our adult guests, please come join us at this time.
Yeah.
streets of San Francisco, ladies and gentlemen, here they come. Every one of you for coming out and making Jennifer's party so special, and on behalf of Star Trek's, along with Melanie, Emily, Bradley, and Mary, my name is Todd, and we want to thank you. Of course, this night is far from being over, but why don't you go ahead? And on the count of three, we're going to walk the circle in and give the Wilders a great big hug. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Go get them. Oh, group hugs, group hugs.